Thank you. Stacy and Phillips, Long Belly. Thank you. We're going to bring some more people up, and I want to explain this song that I'm going to do. You know, I know you look at every part of the performer up here. You look at their shoes. You look at how, whether they took the time to put a clean shirt on. And you look and say, well, gee, you know, he doesn't look as old as his pictures. But about a year ago, I became a grandfather for the first time. As far as I know, thank you. And it's a little baby girl that my daughter had. And I got to thinking, I would really like to hear my grandfather's voice again. But back when he was roaming the earth, they didn't have easy ways to record things. And I said, you know, I'm gonna make a recording for this granddaughter, this first granddaughter, whose name is Matilda. Her name is Tilly. And she's just about 11 months old. And I wrote this song. It's kind of has to do with her mother, my daughter. When she came home one day, one of her teachers had taught her to say, you ask her to do something, she'd say to me, okie dokie, artichokey. So this is called Okie Dokie Artichokey, and you know all these guys, by golly. We're gonna see what happens. One, two, three. Okie dokie, okie dokie, okie dokie, okie dokie, okie dokie, okie do. Artichokey, 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 chokey, choo. Itsy bitsy, itsy bitsy, itsy bitsy, itsy bitsy, itsy bitsy, bitsy boo. Oops a daisy, 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 daisy do. This little song doesn't mean a thing. That's why it's such fun to sing. Won't you try to sing along? Sing with me a silly song. Okie dokie, okie dokie, okie dokie. Okey dokey, dokey, okey do. Artichokey, 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 chokey, joining us. So before we get to the entertainment part of our set, I just wanted to tell you that I've been kind of worried about my wife. And we've been married for about 35 years, and I think her hearing is starting to go. And you know, I talked to her and she's kind of vain. I can't get her to go to the doctor and get her ears checked. So I really don't know what to do. So I went to my doctor and I said, Doc, how can I get through to my wife that she needs to get her ears checked? And he said, well, you go home and I want you to try this and report back to me. I want you to go in the front door and say, honey, I'm home, what's for dinner? And see if she reacts. And then go a little closer in and do the same thing, and you tell me what happened. So I went home, and we got one of these houses where I can see right down the hall, and she's in front of the sink, and she's getting dinner ready. I open the door, I go, honey, I'm home, what's for dinner? Nothing, not a peep. So I go into the living room, and I said, you've had this happen, probably. No. Honey, I'm home. What's for dinner? Nothing. So I go right up next to the poor thing, and I go, honey, I'm home. What's for dinner? And she throws down her peeler, and she turns around and says, chicken for the third time. Am I right? It happens. So we're going to take a chance. These folks have been so nice to come up and do this experiment with me. And I just want to, before I do that, thank all of you for being here this week, tonight. I know some of you are from town and you came in to see the show. And wasn't it a good show? Oh, man. And I want to thank Donna and Steve for working so hard to make this thing come off. It looks to you like it comes off really easily. And for us, it does. I think they have to do more work than we do. But I want to thank them for having me out here. I know we all thank them for putting on this great week. Okay, so here's the crux of the matter. I'll get right to it. We are all teachers here, and I bet that every one of these people on the stage has been browbeating their students to get out there and play with other people. I know Keith over here, he has jam sessions probably 6 or 7 times a day, organizes things, and one of the things we all say to people after we say, you gotta go out and play, is we say, now remember to tell who you're playing with, what the song is, what the key is, how it's gonna go, whatever. Have that prepared. So I thought what I would do is ask them to come up, and I'd like you all to raise your right hands, each one of you on stage, not you, swear, just have to say I swear, don't actually swear though. I swear that I have never heard this song before.
I swear that I've never heard this song before.
Yes, okay, so that means we didn't rehearse it. I didn't tell them the key, I didn't tell them nothing. So I want to show you how we would put this together. If we were at a recording session, we'd do it just this way. The difference is at a recording session, we'd probably do it 2 or 3 times. We're only gonna do it once. So we're gonna play a song in the key of C, and then we're gonna mess around with it. This is a song I wrote, so I know they've never heard it. I usually get a laugh on that line. You can play. We're going to play in the key of C. I'm going to start it out. It's just 3 chords in the key of C, and those chords are?
C, F, G7.
Very good. This is going to go on your permanent record, folks, and it's good. So I'm going to do a little rhythmic intro to this, and then I'm going to sing the chorus 1 time, and you guys will get the chords from that. It's going to come in on the 5 chord. It'll be pretty obvious how it's gonna go. And then I'm gonna do the introduction, I'm gonna back myself up on the first chorus, which is the same chords as the first verse and the second verse and the second chorus, everything else. You'll see. I get blue on account of you and the way you do. Boy, you make me blue. You make me cry, got bloodshot eyes. You make me blue, blue. club or in the line league. Now won't you tell me, please? Then won't you tell me true? What did you do? Wasting your love.